All right, guys, so what do we have? Is it alt season already? I would still remain quite skeptical about it, but yes, we have like 5 to 10% rise in many of the altcoins, even biggest ones like XRP, like Ether, like Litecoin. And if you remember a couple of videos ago, I told you that if you would consider to enter altcoins or at least have some hope for their growth in future, then it might be the point when it will happen. So indeed, we see this growth, and let's see what to expect right now, whether there is some substantial and constant growth or just a dead cat bounce, and we'll see continuation of the bleeding period. Simply starting from Ether, of course, yes, we broke this resistance, we had a nice volume and several green days, even with respect to Bitcoin, which is really good. And in fact, if you remember, we were looking at the major indicators before, let's say on a daily time frame for Ether, as for many other altcoins, we have the bullish divergence. So these lows are going lower, the lows on the indicator, let's say RSI, stochastic or stochastic RSI, or MACD, they all go up, meaning that at this point we have a high probability of the reversal. So this is indeed what happened, and it's pretty much the same for all the major altcoins. See XRP also lower lows, higher lows on the indicator. Bitcoin Cash the same, but happened a bit earlier. Litecoin also the same thing. EOS exactly the same. So all of them are looking pretty much similar. But again, the major question is whether we will have the continuation of the growth or not. Let's say we'll look at the price action of Ether happened during the recent year, like 6 to 9 months. We had actually a lot of pullbacks in the history of Ether, like this one, for example, a very convincing one. But here we didn't make a higher high, and then we continued to go down. This one was more like a manipulative pullback, and it was clear actually afterwards that we will not go anywhere higher. So technically, the current one is better than the previous ones, only in the way that it actually happened after all the major indicators are very much oversold and we are at the kind of a bottom point and the price is also very low. But you see, even for example at this point we also had a very oversold condition, not to mention that on the weekly time frame we had, for example, here the bullish divergence, which we don't have right now. And even after that, on a bigger volume, we couldn't make the continuation of the growth and we went down. So again, I would be very, very cautious calling this alt season. And the simplest, the safest way, which I would say one can do right now, is if you actually managed to buy right here, if you didn't get scared and so-called bought the dip, then you can actually put a stop loss in this area, probably below this low. So if the price will actually continue to go up, you will be fine. If not, then probably the support will hold and will continue to go up. And moreover, I would be very cautious in the local condition, because you can look at RSI, stochastic, MACD, all of them are pretty high right now. And every time when we had such overbought state of those indicators, yes, of course, you can have another leg to the upside, but eventually we will have a correction. And right now we have like a few consecutive days, so I wouldn't be really surprised if we'll finally go down from that point. And again, pretty much the same for all the other major altcoins. XRP really high, Bitcoin Cash is really high, Litecoin, so all of them, well, actually Litecoin and EOS are not that overbought right now, but that's just because they didn't grow as much as Ether and XRP, for example. But still, I would be careful buying them right now. I would be probably wait for the pullback, although again, as I say, they may have another leg to the upside, just as Ether made in this major correction. But in one way or another, I would stick with my stance on the altcoins, that although it's very tempting to buy and hope for the continuation of the growth, the risk reward ratio is not that great as you would want to. By the way, if you remember, we were looking at the ratio of the longs and shorts both for Bitcoin and Ether, and people were saying like, we have so many longs and so few shorts, so probably would not go up until this ratio will be opposite. But instead, despite actually of that, we still had this pullback, and this is normal. But saying that, it doesn't mean that we will continue to go up with such a huge number of longs. So once again, congratulations with profits if you have any. But again, this is just like 5-10% max on Bitcoin, and I wouldn't be overly excited about it. Me personally, I would continue to look at the Bitcoin price action, which happens to be pretty boring recently, but I think we'll soon see some kind of resolution of this sideways price action. And tomorrow we'll look at the very interesting indicator, namely the BitMEX funding index, which is only one, I think, at the moment, in my personal opinion, that shows the very high chance for the decrease in price. Do you remember last videos, maybe few videos, I was saying that I lean towards bullish scenario that will probably go up, maybe with a temporal and a short drop below the support of 9,500, something like that. So like a false breakdown and then continuation. Was this is the worst scenario in my opinion. But again, there is more chance to go to the upside in a long term. So despite of that, short term, there is a very strong indication that will go down. So tomorrow we'll cover this and look at why I actually still remain in my long position and not opening my short on Bitcoin just exactly right now. And finally, I have an important announcement today that I finally made this hard and painful decision to separate my English and Russian content on this channel into two channels. So I will continue to post videos in both languages on this one for maybe a few days or something like a week, but there will be a separate channel in English. I will leave the link down below, so I would really appreciate if you will actually subscribe to the second one. Hope that it would be easier for you to have only English content here, because I already had like a few requests about that. Alright guys, that is it for today. I hope that it was useful. Thank you for watching.